Prem Sagar's blog number 2, Shri Ramanand Sagar's Kundli and Analyzation. Pitru Devo Bhava. Kitna hi dan sanpati lutayen, pitru ka rin na chuke, na chukaye. I personally feel Papaji was born to rewrite Ramayan in electronic medium. Valmiki ji wrote poetry, and Sant Tulsidas wrote in Avadhi language, and Dr. Ramanand Sagar rewrote Ramayan in TV medium. The impact of Ramayan was so great that it became the highest viewed serial in the world as per BBC, 650 million viewership. And his struggle life is something extraordinary for any human being, I would say. And it would be very interesting to analyze his astrological journey. Our great sages, rishis like Bhrigu and Parashar, they defined human life maximum as 120 years. They divided these 120 years into 9 segments of different length, and they called it Mahadashas. For example, Saturn or Shani was for 19 years, Chandra or Moon was for 10 years, Surya, Sun, 6 years, so on and so forth. Now, these Mahadashas are decided upon our Nakshatra. But how are Nakshatras calculated? Chandra Dev married 27 daughters of Daksh Prajapati. And the moon goes round the earth in 28 days. One day it's a full moon, Puranmashi. The other 27 days it stays in each section for one day. And this is called Nakshatra. So the names of the 27 wives like Rohini, Bhairavi, Revati, Anuradha, Chitra, each of the 27 wives becomes one nakshatra. This nakshatra decides the astrological chart of where the planets will be there and what will be the length of the Mahadashas. Now, as far as Papaji is concerned, he was born in Asal Guruke, which is east, purva of Lahore, 40 kilometers. And his first Mahadasha was Guru or Jupiter from 1970 to 1930. And during this period, he faced a lot of struggle, and Guru always protected him because Guru protects you. He was adopted Bhanj woman, and his mother could not take the of losing her child or seeing her child in such circumstances. Ramanand Sagar's father had promised Bhagushai, who couldn't get a child, that my first child, I will give it to you in adoption. So Ramanand Sagar was given to Bhagushai as an adopted baby. And she, being a money lender, was very cruel to children. She would beat Papaji, throw a pitcher or a lota at him because he had not cleaned the bartans correctly or the pots correctly or the crockery correctly. And that mark on his forehead was one of them. And he had a very struggleful period, to the extent that his mother, Isha Devi, could not take it. And she became a drug addict, and she died at the tender age of 26 when Papaji was only 9 years old. So this Guru Mahadasha prepared the ground for him to go further in life. Then from 30 to 49, his Mahadasha of Shani started for 19 years. Shani grinded him, taught him the meaning of life, made him rise as a creative person, as a spiritual person. In 1933, he wrote a small short story at the age of 16, Pritam Pariksha, which had reflections of Krishna and a gopi in the Vrindavan. During this Mahadasha, he had to go through grinding of life. He had to sell soaps in the streets. He was a peon in an office. He struggled as a writer, as a journalist, became the editor of Daily Milap. In 41, he got TB and he was almost given up for dead. He was at his deathbed, and how he survived back and bounced back because he started writing a column, Maut ke Bistar Se, or I would say Diary of a TB Patient, published in Adab-e-Mushrik, which skyrocketed him in the literary world of Lahore and accepted. By the end of Shani Mahadisha in 1948, he wrote Barsat for Raj Kapoor. Barsat was a super hit and it collected about 1.1 crore at that time, which is about 600-700 crores today. RK Studio was made from that money, and RK banner logo was from that movie. Ramanand Sagar became a big name overnight. Then from 49 to 66, his Budh Mahadasha started. Budh is Mercury and it's a planet of business. So Budh gave him the fundamental grinding of creativity and business and taught him. But started at a note which was frightening. After Barsat, having been a big name, people backed him. And he made two films. They were both super flops. But one was of the flop to the extent, first day, first show, not a single ticket sold. That was Bazubad. And the first film was Mehman. Big star cast, Premnath, Sajjan, Purnima. But the film didn't run. It brought the whole family to the street. Our struggle period started. And we had to walk to school for 4 miles. We had no bus fare. We would take our chapatis with just salt and a little white butter. It was a struggle period. But during that period, he was picked up by Gemini. And there his graph rose. He made Ghumghat, the biggest ever hit in black and white. He made Insaniyat, he made Paigam, he made big hits for Gemini. He publicly declared that my guru in filmmaking is Mr. S.S. Vasan, the head henchman of Gemini. He learnt his craft there. He made lot of big hits, Ghumghat, Zindagi, as a producer with Gemini's help. And after 66, he came to Bombay, and from Ramanand Chopra, he became Ramanand Sagar. And his golden period started of Ketu for 7 years. Whatever he touched turned into gold. Arzu, Aankhe, Geet, Lalkar. He made 6 silver jubilee hits in a row. I don't know of the Indian Hindi film industry if anybody would have that kind of a record. From 73 to 93, his period of fame, his period of success, his period of make history for himself. During this period, though initially he didn't make successful films, because then he had to shift to TV, and because of that he made Ramayan and Krishna, which were the crowning glory. As I told you, Ramayan was the highest viewed serial. Ramayan brought tenements of, you know, Maryada Purushottam to the youngsters. And from 93 to 99, his Surya Mahadasha started for 6 years. During this period, Krishna shifted to DD1 and became the highest earner ever for DD, giving them 135 crores only as airtime. And Krishna viewership was something not happened, but he had to struggle very hard to get Krishna, struggle very hard to get Ramayan, because some political parties were aware that if Hinduism jagrat ho jayega, so then they might lose the battle. BJP from 2 seats in 1985 got 85 seats in 1989 after Ramayan, and 161 seats after Krishna. Then from 1999 to 2009, his Chandra Madhisha started. And during this period, he had gone into a different zone of spiritualism. And on 12th December 2005, he left for Vaikuntham.